Dave and I are going to do North Gate at low water. Min recommended level. We'll see how it goes. Yeah, man. I'm psyched. It's been a while since I've done this run.
Nice.
It's been mellow, real mellow first part of the float. We should have brought our fishing rod. A lot of fire scars. Apparently there's no camping in this section within 1,000 feet of the center line due to the fires and runoff, according to the Forest Service. So we're just doing this as a day trip. It's beautiful down here.
Alright.
to stay in your boat. Looks like right and then left between those two, those that gap.
Left in that?
Left in that gap right there. Yeah. So I'm gonna run it right.
Yep, right to left.
Yeah, right of this big pillow rock. That where it's pillowing, and then there.
Yeah.
And I'll get up to that big rock there and take another look, I guess. So. That's it. All right, ready.
Almost.
Hey. That wasn't quite. Let's do that again. That man, that line sucked.
I can do it again.
All right, I'll do it again. How's it going, guys? Good. take another run at that. Yeah, my paddle's over there. Thanks. Where'd it go? Do you see it? It's up above me? It's way back in there? Fuck. Ah, shit. I'm not going in there.
It looked to me like there was a fair amount of water going underneath that face. Just the lack of pillowing water in front of it. And it was pretty deep. It was, you know... It was a good 6 feet into the corner. It just didn't seem like a smart idea to paddle in there with my little boat and then possibly end up making a situation worse. You can see the tip of my paddle sticking up there vertically. So we had to rethink this.
So I decided that right now would be a good time to do a little live bait practice. So we attached a couple throw ropes to me, one upstream and one directly behind me. And I swam out there to go check it out.
Quickly realized that the water was in fact moving down the face of that rock, and so much so that every time I tried to get my leg around there and my torso, the water was just ripping my shorts right off. So I quickly decided that this was probably not the best way to go about this.
Deep.
Strong.
Oh fuck no, not without getting pulled under. That water's just going down. It's ripping my shorts off.
Look how it's like tombstoning the fucking paddle.
Now, not long after that, this raft came down behind us and kindly paddled over there and grabbed my paddle.
I know, it's all my fault.
Boat. Take a whole lot to pull that thing down.
So, you guys rock!
So I got my paddle back and I didn't have to paddle out without a paddle. I was eternally grateful.
Oh, you guys are awesome. Thanks. Yeah, I did. I videoed it for you guys. Thank you guys. Thanks so much. That's
cool,
awesome.
No, I'm glad. That's always nice.
Yeah, what's your name? This is why they don't have any camping in here right now. It's because of all of these rock slides and mud slides.
from the fire washout. They are at every ravine in here.
So this is Tootsie Roll Rapid, and I got a huge droplet of water on my lens right off the bat, and it just would not go away. I decided to go ahead and keep this footage in here because if you're interested in seeing this run, then this is still somewhat useful. It's such a shame that that droplet hung on so long, because this was really a long and fun rapid. Someone can correct me if I'm wrong on the name of this. But yeah, this was definitely just a blast.
Yep, with only a minor carnage.
I got it on tape.
That's good. You know, I think I could have paddled down without my paddle the rest of that.
It'd be hard.
It would have been a little difficult. This is it. This is our takeout. Yeah, I think a little bit more water would have made it a little easier.
I think we need more water.
Yeah, but
100 more CFS.
It was doable at this level.
Yeah.
Just a little bony.
Very.
Yep.